So what just means to me, in support of a pair, I feel cool a bee. A common zoo, I feel one for Agnum Braddle. No can I feel by the announcement. No one kills in soon quarter. So I pair next year, in short, German number 70 daughter. I want to, but 15 years of what you are, this will be here. Oh, no, my dad is Israel. I died in Saudi Arabia. Sana sunjabo memo no ye 30 years awu ye nyimo ngwa akum abona funya akum nyala ala papa bi da azu ka kire ho afi ka kire ho asam maka afi manu tra jo afi na asase ye djuma azu ka kire ho o bi bi la lo ba sun ye tutu sun na ne papa ampin do abon osme papa na fiwo o bi bi la lo ba sun ye tutu sun na na maami ampin abon sun mu osme maami na fiwo o bi bi la lo abon sun mu na ne kun I'm probably so much more you can have one. It's the easiest show the whole. Young Copan or Dinaman, then being Amelia Dinaman, as you want some of them. Now, and see, and Yaz answered the water. Son of my better hatchet. I hope he no one may more. I watch you, you bought your input, you so walk out, and she must walk to watch in the man, what did the man walk out? Yeah, I'm not making much, my Adan to watch you. So be a major swimming to me, and I'm so on fighting on the sun. Oh, yeah, who put it to me? Since I'm going to say US. Since I'm going to say, why for me US? German, of course, war bar, Italy, food bar, spend 1 hour with all the other. No, Miss Obaquai, you know, I mean, I'm going to say, but when I'm going to find a washman, I'm going to say, but I'm for 100 or you're going to find a way with it. The one washman was a washman, I mean, I'm going to say, the crack, this is US team because I brought for another woman. Oh, yeah, bro, one of them. And so, what's what catch on for my crack? My woman was over. And so, what no more or summon, what do you are seeing now? But you are seeing now where gentlemen are 170 years on my account for them. 100 and 200, I should be the moment with that. I was about a coffee with him. And what you are seeing yet again, maybe. Oh, yeah, I should see you as one of the cool.
I'm not doing it. Have you heard about it? Have you heard about the third temple and the third religion and the new Messiah who is here to save the world and to join Islam and Christianity as one faith?
2009, 2014.
Okay.
And the one who claims he is bigger than the Lord Jesus Christ? Now, according to their leader, he has been hearing this voice since he was 13, and that voice has led him through all his life, teaching him and showing him a lot of things. And in 2009, the voice prompted him to start a ministry. In 2014, that same voice came to him that he should join Islam and Christianity under a new religion and to call it Asumdwe Ntontomsom. And that the voice told him that no one knows God in this country, nobody is serving God in this country, and so he should start this new religion so that he will bring everybody under this one big umbrella to serve God. He said from that time, which has been over 8 years, he's gathered over 17,000 people. And he claims he doesn't have time to study the Bible nor read the Quran, but the voice that speaks to him, which started around age 13, has been speaking to him concerning any matter of dispute that is brought to him regarding the Bible, regarding the Quran, and even many things that are wrong in the Bible. He is able to correct them. Things that are wrong with Islam and Quran, he is able to correct them.
And yes, I see. Now, man, can't correct them. But in purport, I don't believe in purport. I want to mention what I'm saying. Now, but I'm not saying. And to some of the rest, I'm saying, you can't say nothing. Now, I'm going to then we make the empire argument 17,000. Oh, in fact, what you need? And this American saying, "Bien, na ejehuchime." I want to say, "Babu all the way, Korea all the way." Papa, me, mama, me, be a milk question. So I say, "Me, I'm ready to go." And I'm going to be the kind saying, "Bien, na madam, I'm going to question." I'm going to be the one saying, "Na, kasi abe kache no kusha, baku no shaho." In passing, you have Babu no. On to them, I walk me racing. I'm one of them high. What's I?
He also claimed that every messenger that comes from God is given a book. Muhammad has a book. Jesus brought the New Testament. He also has been given a book, the Power Book. He claimed that he used to be an Islamist preacher who used to go around preaching Islam. Then the voice spoke to him to start this new religion. Note that, put that aside, because in our subsequent video concerning him, we are going to bring that up when we analyze his belief, the basis for doing the things he is doing. Now, the 17,000 people that he talked about was about 2 years ago, and from all indications, he might have doubled those numbers by now, or he will be close to doing that. Now, this means that we need to start asking very relevant questions and seeking relevant answers to them before it is too late, because 17,000, if he is false, is a huge number to be lost. And so we want to ask one question and to answer it today. We are going to have a subsequent video where we critically analyze his belief system and the reason for doing all the things he is doing. This is the question: does the word of God or the Bible speak about the coming of other messengers of God and religions after Jesus Christ? We need to find out, does the word of God speak about the coming of other messengers of God and religions after Jesus Christ? Now, this is a Christian platform. I am a Christian, and as a Christian, the Bible is our primary and only source document. We don't believe in Islam, we don't believe in the Quran, so we can't go to them to use them to prove anything. If you are a Christian who believes in the Christian worldview, it means that you have no acceptance for Islam. So we are not going to go delve into their book. We are going to use strictly the Bible to answer this question. We believe Islam is actually a fulfillment of one of the prophecies of the Lord Jesus Christ that says that many false prophets and messiahs will come after him that will deceive many. So we can't consult with them at all. Now, this will be the only question we'll endeavor to answer in this video. But in the next one, we'll do concerning the Asumdwe Ntuntumsum and Nyame Sumafuyawo. I'll analyze his teachings and basis for their new religion whilst comparing and contrasting with the truth of God in the Bible. So let's answer it. Do we have any assurance of new religions, new messiahs in the Bible? Hebrews chapter 1:1-2 says, in the past, God spoke to our forefathers through the prophets at many times and in various ways. But in these last days, he has spoken to us by his Son, whom he appointed heir of all things and through whom he made the universe. Let me add another verse. John 14:6-7 says, Jesus answered, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you really knew me, you will know my Father as well. From now on, you do know him and have seen him. Now, these two verses mean that apart from Jesus Christ, there's no way to God. Nobody can go to God. And so anybody who comes after Jesus Christ, who claims to be a prophet, should be preaching Jesus Christ. There's no room for anybody to preach any other way, because Jesus Christ has unambiguously stamped it that nobody is going to God apart from him. And in the scriptures, we see that Jesus Christ is differentiated from all prophets. He is higher than Moses, Abraham, everybody in the Bible. And then those are not just claims about the Lord Jesus Christ by just words that he is bigger than them. He was proven to be all that he claims to be, the biggest of them, the Son of God, by the resurrection from the dead. Romans 1:4 says, and who through the Spirit of holiness was declared with power to be the Son of God by his resurrection from the dead, Jesus Christ our Lord. And that was also not a fulfillment in randoms, like something that happened in random. That was an Old Testament. There was an Old Testament prophecy about the Messiah that he will not be abandoned to the grave. And so when Jesus resurrected from the grave, it was the final certification that he is actually the one appointed of God, the one approved of God, the one that nobody can contest. Look at that. Psalm 16:8-11 says, I have set the Lord always before me. Because he is at my right hand, I will not be shaken. Therefore, my heart is glad and my tongue rejoices. My body also will rest secure, because you will not abandon me to the grave. Now, in Acts chapter 2, Apostle Peter explained this. David was buried, his grave was with them. So if David was talking about himself, he was abandoned to the grave. But this was actually about the Messiah, the seed of David, who will not be abandoned to the grave. Jesus Christ, who resurrected on the third day after he was buried and crucified on the cross. So this is airtight. There is no room for another messenger after Jesus Christ, after his resurrection, after he was proven to be the Son of God with his resurrection. Any others who comes after the Lord Jesus are supposed to preach the Lord Jesus Christ. If they try to bring a new way, they are liars, they are false prophets, and they are false messiahs. Matthew 24:24-25 says, for false Christ and false prophets will appear and perform great signs and miracles to deceive even the elect. If that were possible. See, I've told you ahead of time. So we are not expecting any new religion. We are not expecting any new temple. In fact, Jesus said a time is coming, now is, true worshippers will worship in spirit and in truth. It will not be about temples. The Lord just said to the woman at the well, you worship what you don't know, but we the Jews, we know what we worship. Then he told him, a time is coming. It will not be about going to this mountain or going to Jerusalem and to the temple. It will not be about places. It will not be about temples. But the time is coming when true worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and in truth, for the Father seeketh such. So the idea of a new temple is invalidated by the Lord Jesus Christ. The idea of a new Messiah is invalidated by the Lord Jesus Christ. And then the idea of a third religion is invalidated by the Lord Jesus Christ. This is the time for you to sit up and learn the truth. God bless you. I'll see you in the next one when we make a video concerning the Asumdwe and Tuntumsum and their messenger, and to critically analyze what they believe. God bless you. I'll see you in the next one. Shalom.